Hi, welcome to an Arduino tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to measure the distance using ultrasonic sensor and display it as a bar graph on the LCD screen. You can get the code for this by clicking at the link below the video in the description, which will take you to robojax.com/learn/Arduino. Let's get started with this. There are many instances that you need to display the distance measured using this ultrasonic sensor as a bar graph. The advantage of displaying as a bar graph is that with comparing to number, bar graph can easily be understood. For example, right now the maximum is set at 20 centimeters, and immediately we know the middle is half. Without even reading this from further distance, you can read it. And we can even go to 20 and it will be full. In this video, I'm going to explain how to get the bar graph. I have a separate video explaining how to use this display with complete explanation. The link will be provided. Also, another video that explains this ultrasonic sensor. I'm not going to do the full detail of this. Our concern is to just display the bar graph. Now, let me explain the wiring. I will show you the wiring here. If you need a wiring diagram, the link is below. You can get it from my course at Udemy. For this hardware, we have four pins. SCL, that is a clock, SDA, SCL and SDA. We have two pins on Arduino here, SCL and SDA. If your Arduino doesn't have it, alternatively also you can use analog 4 and analog 5. Analog 4 is SDA and analog 5 is SCL. You can connect it in here. If you're using other devices, for example, Uno Ethernet, SDA is A4, A5 is SCL, Arduino Mega, 20 is SDA, and 21 is SCL, and the Northern Duo, they have been all mentioned. I will provide you the link for this as well. Then we have VCC, blue, have been connected to 5 volts of Arduino, and then GND or ground, the green, have been connected to ground of Arduino. For ultrasonic sensor, we have VCC, this purple, have been connected to pin 2, which have been defined as additional 5 volts. And then trig and echo. Trig is gray, have been connected to pin 11. And echo is white, have been connected to pin 12 of Arduino. The last pin is ground, black, have been connected in here because we have additional ground available here. I've spent quite some time writing the code, testing it and making sure it works and providing you the code. The least that you can do for me, please subscribe. You don't lose anything and it will be a great help and it will be appreciated. Let me now explain the code. The first thing that you need to do is we need to download two libraries. One library is the liquidcrystal_I2C. That is the I2C module that is here and behind us. And then we have to include the LCD bar graph Robojax, which is the updated version. I've taken the original library from this address, from the playground, and it was not working with this. So I have updated and worked and changed many places and customized it with adding some feature so it can work easily with this. Now you have to download it. I will provide you the link. This can be used without using the ultrasonic or the graph. So this is generally, you need this for this purpose. So this library is needed, but for bar graph, we are adding this on top of that. So if you have this, do not worry, and then just add this. In both cases, the link will be provided. So you have to download it as zip file and save it in your computer. So you have two separate files that you have to download as zip. After that, click on sketch, include library, and then add .zip library. When you click on that, point it to where you have saved it. It says Robojax USB relay.zip. This is another example. You just click to the zip that you have downloaded and click open. This way the library will be added, and do the same thing for both. Once that is done, then the examples will be loaded with this that I have written. Click on file, examples, and then scroll down until you see R, Robojax, bar graph, and then go to ultrasonic. Once you click, this is a file that will be opened. Now let me now explain it. This wire.h is part of like Arduino IDE. You don't need to do anything. This you just downloaded these two and include it. From here you set the number of characters. This is 16 characters and two lines. This two means number of lines. And then we use a class, create an instance of it, and we call it LCD. And then it has three parameters here. The first one is the I2C address for this tiny device that is communicating. Instead of multiple lines, we are sending data here via serial communication. And the number of columns that we have, and then LCD line, number of lines. We have to pass these three to the class. To find this address, you need to run I2C scanner, and I2C scanner, the link will be provided once you add it. Let me open I2C scanner. Once that open, do not worry what is inside it. The only thing that you need to worry is to make sure that right COM ports have been selected and uploaded. Now the code will be uploaded to Arduino. After that, click on the serial monitor and it will print the address for you. It says 0x3f. And then we use this address. Let me upload the code back. And then we use that address in here. After that, we use the LCD bar graph Robojax class and we create an instance of it. We call it RGX, and when we pass this LCD with this ampersand here, and then number of columns of the LCD, and then the position, character 0, line 0, which is displayed in here. This include ping. New ping is for this device. For this ultrasonic sensor, it is part of Arduino library. You don't need to do anything, it will just work fine. And then we define the trigger pin number 11, echo pin number 12, and maximum distance. I've set it 60 depending on your application. You have to put that so the calculation can be done properly to display the maximum. If you set this 60, the 60 maximum will be here and the 30 will be at the middle and so forth. So make sure to put the amount that you are using so you can get the proper proportional graph. And then you ping sonar. This is an instance of this class, and we are passing the trigger pin, echo pin, and maximum distance for the class to work. Because we are connecting these two, this needs 5 volts, this needs 5 volts. In some Arduinos, you do not have 5 volts, even though I had here 5 volts, extra 5 volts, but I've defined pin 2 as 5 volts. So we can have 2 5 volts, one for this, one for this. One is connected directly to 5 volts, and the other will be connected to pin 2 as extra VCC. And here we have defined VCC2, pin number 2. Inside the setup, using pin mode VCC2, we set this pin as output. So this is outputting the voltage, acting as an output, and using digital write 2, pin 2, as high. This VCC2 is equal to 2, so this is as if I type 2. When we set this as high, the pin, this pin, will always have 5 volts. But with little current, this is not suitable for everything. I have a separate video explaining that. The link will be provided. And this portion is for the LCD. LCD.begin initializes the class for the LCD. LCD.clear clears the value, the previous value, in case if it exists. And then LCD print, inside this double quotation, we put a text, Robojax, which will be displayed on the first line. And then we set the cursor 01. We go to the line 1, character 0, to the next line, and we print bar graph. Let me reset this so you can see it. Reset. It will be quick. Robojax bar graph. So this is the text, and then we give the user for 2 seconds to see it. After that, we clear the screen and we go inside the loop. Whatever code we have inside the loop will run continuously. The first line, we use sonar.pingcm. This will get the distance in centimeter, and store it in here. So this is the value, and we say equal to this, and we put a distance cm. Then we also get the inch, and we put a distance in. I'm using centimeter in case if you're using inch. Inside the code, wherever we see this, replace it with this. And then here, Robojax clear line one. We are clearing line zero, line one, continuously, so it can read new value for us. And we don't clear this one because the class is taking care of that, the graph class. And then we set LCD cursor to character zero, line one, and we print this the word distance with colon. And then we set the cursor at character 10. If we count this, you will see that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. At 10, we are putting it, and we say distance cm. It will print the distance for us as centimeter. And then we go to character 14. This is 10, 14. So 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. At 14, we print cm again inside double quotation because it's a text. This doesn't have any quotation because it is a variable that has value. Then we wait 100 milliseconds, and the loop continues like that. And here is a demonstration. At the moment, it is set to 20 centimeter, and it perfectly shows the distance as bar graph. If I go further than 20 centimeter, because the ultrasonic sensor is automatically disabled beyond that distance, you will get zero. That's the maximum distance that shows 20. If I make this, for example, 60, you will see that the whole span of this bar graph from here to here will be for 60. And for example, 15 centimeter will show somewhere in here. So four of this have been taken, and then 8 is 30, and then 16 is 60. So if I move this, you will see that 30 is just there. And if I point it to the laptop screen, right now it shows around 60. Now let's say you want to have the bar graph. Instead of starting from here, you want it to start from the middle, let's say character 8. And if you pay attention, the LCD call number columns. So this is number of column because we wanted to fill up this. It was 16. Now let's change it to 8 character, and then we want to start from 8. So this is the length, this is the start, and this is the line 0. If you want to move it to the next one, change this to 1. So let's see. Change for 20 centimeter. So now this is 16 centimeter, and if I go 20, it will fill it up. Now I've inserted this larger size. It will not work because the address for this is not 3F, so I have to change the address. The address is 0x27. And then also the number of characters is 20, and number of line is 4. Now the bar graph is being calculated for 20 characters, which is this would compare it to this, the 16 is here, so we have 4 extra characters. I changed it to 30, it's displayed a bar graph. This is at this line, at line 40 is where you change the location of the bar graph to be displayed. So 0, 0 means it goes with line 0, character 0, And if I want to display the bar graph in here, it will be line 012, so I'll put 02. Let me change this to that 0, just change this to 2 and upload the code. And you will see the bar graph have been moved to the next line, and the same way you can change those as well. Thank you for watching. This was how to display the distance using ultrasonic sensor on the LCD screen. I hope you've learned something. Please don't forget to thumb up the video. If you have comment or question, post it. I try to answer and reply. Don't forget to subscribe and leave the notification on. Thank you.